Who here likes music? So I decided for my training set project, why not go ahead and do something that I do all the time anyways, which is work on horse training.
And so here goes me and my crew. As you can see, you know, we're sitting in a chair one day, shamelessly wasting.
My name's Austin.
And I'm Caroline.
And we welcome you to December 21 tutorials.
The spirit introduced to us one day, 20% project. Ooh, it was actually pretty interesting to us because, first of all, there are no rules. We don't really like rules.
So, once upon a time, our teacher gave us the opportunity to explore.
Every day we thought about the endless possibilities.
One day we had an idea. Because of that, we were inspired to try our best. And so finally we ended up with this idea.
Hello, I'm Sia.
And I'm Kikita.
And we're Take Tabulous.
The game we have created involves many different barriers. The one that is shown on the screen is the upward barrier, which the user would spike up to be able to avoid it. Another barrier that we have included in the game is the downward barrier, where the user would swipe down and avoid. Then two more that we included are the double upwards and the double downwards barrier, which are kind of the same thing, but they require more precise timing to be able to avoid.
If we could use one word to describe our project, it would be create.
One day, we thought of creating comics, and we were both excited because we both had a family like Don.
This was homemade caramel versus store-bought caramel. The homemade caramel serving size is 3.5 times the store-bought caramel.
We didn't just collect thousands of pop tabs because we liked how shiny they looked. We collected them to be donated to the local Ronald McDonald Houses of Georgia.
5, 6, 7, 8.
One day the spirit said, get ideas in your head. We thought of everything. There was one that was fun. We needed to build an empire.
It was really fast.
Hey guys, today we're going to make another airplane, paper airplane. It's called the Oldtimer.
Once upon a time, in a middle school called River Trail, there were two people, Amy and Barnaby. One day, they decided that some of the books in the library were too tiresome and predictable.
Because of that, they had a sudden burst of inspiration. They were each going to write their own original, innovative novels.
Because of that, on the day, their very notable teacher, Ms. Fear, announced that they were having a 20% project, where one day of each week was allotted to doing any kind of project of the student's passion, they decided to use that time to write their novels.
And so they opened their Google documents and let their imagination run wild.
What's the place living
in? Our company's name is MJKs.
My name is Ansley Silver, and when I was asked to do a project every Monday for the whole school year by Ms. Fear, I knew I wanted to start a business.
Here's a screenshot of one of our songs, our second song, Cosmic Storm. So we had a few problems during this. One of them was that there was a glitch in the program in which the fuzzy sound would play randomly, and we didn't know how to overcome it.
So instead, we decided to incorporate it into our music and act like it was part of the song. With Remy, he was a special case because we were trying to figure out how to get his head back into the game because he's been working so long on his jumping that he doesn't really pay attention anymore. So what we did was we used a lot of cantering and we used a lot of transitions just to get him, just to surprise him.
But we had another problem. We didn't know how to do that. Get it? Because like this guy's searching. It's funny.
So you might seem shocked, but it actually worked.
And then as soon as we knew Exterior CT was coming, and you know we had to study for that because we had to get those good grades, and we were also getting a bunch of projects and a bunch of other tests, and so we were deciding to restart this entire project. new idea, but because that would take up too much time, we decided to go with what we already have.
So what is a Rube Goldberg?
I know the answer.
Okay.
A Rube Goldberg is a chain of physical chain reactions that lead up to a task. We have learned many things. We have learned that teamwork and cooperation can help us accomplish a task, and not everything goes the way you plan.
Also, color looking that would always be helpful. And it was fun. Not only did we learn these important life skills, but we also developed better friendships outside of school.
Like, we set it up and then it just falls down again. And then we'll be like, okay, let's set it up again. And then it falls down again. And we'd be like, we got kind of frustrated, but you know, we learned like patience is really important. Other than you know, we couldn't get it in one take because it's like almost impossible to get it. You know, it didn't work all the time. And yeah, and sometimes you got frustrated, like listening right now. That's having a good time.
Going.
That's
good.
The ball basically just rolls down and sees the books.
Does it work?
That's very positive. Unfortunately, what happens to me? The cup is supposed to fall down and then pour water into that cup, but watch what happens.
So we're making good progress. We've raised $75 from all our crafts. And we have over 100 people on our website.
And we learned a couple of things. One, we experienced a lot of difficulties with technologies, such as we had a lot of pictures on the iPad that we wanted to like put up on our PowerPoint, but the spirit walked in and told us the iPads were all erased.
And another big problem was we procrastinated too much, and so we decided to...
Okay, we ran into many difficulties during this process, one of which was time. We soon realized that it takes a very long time to be able to develop that.
During this project, we learned many important things, like how to upload photos and create a website. But we also learned some important life lessons.
Just because you're in a team doesn't mean you can't have individuality. Our whole project was about coming up with our own ideas and combining them together to create something spectacular.
We learned that time is precious and limited, and it takes a lot of it to create a website that we were happy with. Occasionally, we would accidentally save over each other's progress, causing us to restart what we had lost. But all in all, this project was born from the perspiration of our fingers on the keyboard and countless late nights. But we are the readers and writers of tomorrow, and we must do the reading and writing.
Throughout the project, we had a few hiccups here and there. I wrote our script on my iPad at school, but it was erased due to an unforeseen error. This was an unforgettable educational lesson because we learned to always back up our learning.
Well, at first we just thought that taking sugar out of the candy would make it less unhealthy. But we found out that it also ruins the taste. Like, for example, for chocolate, if you just take out sugar, the cocoa powder will be really intense and it will taste terrible.
Throughout this experience, we learned many lessons that we hope to carry on our whole life.
I learned how to work as a team and stay organized.
I learned that responsibility and perseverance are rewarding to you and those around you.
We learned many things, including making the videos, editing them, and then uploading them to the websites.
But unfortunately, it's always easier said than done.
I've had a bad case of writer's block. That should be a real disease. I mean, it's common as a cold.
And I don't know what happened to me. I had too many ideas to choose from.
Okay, well, if we knew now what we knew then, we probably would have changed the project up a little bit.
Instead of each writing our own novels, we probably should have collaborated on a single story together.
Like, I would have been the editor, and Amy would have been the writer.
So, I also learned that I need to manage my time really wisely, because if I stop sending questions to the group, then eventually they'll just stop checking, and then they'll stop answering. And that did happen a couple of times. I had to sort of solve that problem. I sent emails to the students themselves, or to their
So getting started was a little difficult because most of our supplies that we needed were from out of the United States. And so we had to order from foreign countries, and that caused a lot of time, and we had to wait before we got to begin anything.
Yeah,
And I realized I need to take a step back and maybe see how I can be useful to the business. So then I had an idea. What if I made charms to go on the phone cases to reduce costs? So we bought some clay and I got started. I turned the bigger charms into keychains, and I turned the smaller ones into earrings and charm bracelets. I had an idea. What if I made advertisement? So I made an Instagram account. It's @sugarishdesign. Be sure to follow us when you get home or have Wi-Fi. And so now customers could view my profile and they could see what I had to offer. Customers could leave comments with questions, and I could also interact with my followers using direct messages, and that's also where they could share their address, so it was private. A big thanks to Ms. Beard for coming up with the crazy idea to let her students do basically whatever they want for the whole year.
Well, there are some people we'd like to thank, and the main person is not only a person who helped us with our 20% project, but helped us day to day and made us want to be the people that we could be the best. And that person we have a guest on already is Ms. Beard, our social studies teacher. Now, Ms. Beard is what you would call a tech genius. Lots of people think that when you take a classroom and you involve technology or any kind of iPad involved, it becomes easier, but that's not really true. Ms. Beard put in countless hours in school and out of school to make us be the best we could be. So she's right there. Thank you, Ms. Beard, so much.